Hi all, today we are going to see a new topic, that is forwarding of IP packets. So coming to forwarding, the main function of network layer is forwarding, right? So what do you mean by the forwarding, the term forwarding? Forwarding means to deliver the packet to the next hop. That is, it can be a final destination or intermediate connecting device. Oh, so you can say forwarding is to deliver a packet to the next hop is called as forwarding, right? So we are going to see, already we are going to see in this how forwarding is done with the help of IP packets. So already we, in the first unit and second unit, we have discussed that forwarding, just the packet will be placed in its route to its destination. That is what we have seen. So now we are going to include IP, internet protocol, along with this while during this forwarding. Okay, so how this IP protocol helps in forwarding, that is what we are going to see in this topic. This forwarding can be done in two ways. One is, the forwarding can be done, it is based on the destination address. It is based on the destination address is one thing. The second one is the forwarding based on labels. Okay, so these are the two topics we are going to see it now. So first we will see on forwarding based on destination address. Okay, coming to forwarding based on destination address, this is the most prevalent approach which is used today also. So this is an approach which is a traditional approach which is prevalent today also. Okay, so today also we are using this approach only, that is forwarding based on destination address. So what happens over here is that whenever a host has a packet to send, or whenever a router has received a packet, what it will do is it will go and check the forwarding table. Okay, so it will go and check the forwarding table, and it looks there, and based on the forwarding table, it will find the next hop. Okay, it will find the next hop to which the particular packet to be delivered. So whenever a packet, a router receives, it will go and check in the forwarding table. Based on the forwarding table suggestion, it will route the packets to the next stop. This is what the function of forwarding table. So now we will see how IP addresses are used, or IP protocol is used in this forwarding table. So we will see how this forwarding is done in classless addressing. So what is classless addressing? Classless addressing, we don't have classes like classful. Here there is no classes, only network addresses will be there, and also there will be a mask which will be represented by slash n, the IP address slash n. This is how you will be representing your classless address. So now we will see how forwarding table uses this classless address to identify the next hop. So in the forwarding table, it has following information. It has following four pieces of information. The first one is mask, the second one is network address, and third is interface number, and fourth is IP address of the next router. IP address of the next router. So these are the four information which is available inside your forwarding table. So whenever any address to be searched in the forwarding table, so the router will go and get the mask, it will go and check the mask first. If this is okay, then it will go and check whether network address matches, and if this is also okay, it will get the interface number, and it will forward that, it will send that the packet to the next hop with the help of the IP address mentioned there. Okay, this is what the forwarding table will do. Now we will see with this example diagram. So now a packet arrives. This is a packet. So what happens here is that here there will be an, it will first, the packet will contain the destination address. So we will extract the destination address. Okay, we'll find out the destination address. From the destination address, it will go and search in the forwarding table. Okay, in the table, this is the forwarding table. So forwarding table contains all these information. As I've told you, it contains four information. So here you have, the first one is network address, which includes mask. The second one is next hop IP address, and third is interface. Okay, these are the information which is available in the forwarding table. So what happens is that, so whenever a packet arrives, so here it will go and first it will extract the destination address from the packet. It will go and search in the table. So the example is, so this is an IP address x0.y0.z0.t0/n0. okay, this is one classless IP address, and you have one more x1.y1.z1.t1/n1 and x2.y2.z2.t2/n2. So this is a mask and this is an IP address, network address. So here we can give the next IP address over here, then interface number also we can specify it over here. So based on if any destination address matches with any of the address over here, it will find out the interface through which the packet should be forwarded, and it will also give you the IP address, next hop IP address also. Based on this, the packet can be forwarded to the next hop. Okay, we will see how forwarding table is built. So this is an example forwarding table which is built with the help of the router information. Okay, so this is a router R1, so which is having four organization which is being connected through the interface M1, M0, M3 and M2. So suppose over here this is one organization. So here you can see that, that is, you have several systems in that. One system is connected to M1, and all these organization you have many other systems. Here only for time being I have mentioned only one system which is having an address called 201.4.16.2.22. usually the first address of the block, so for the entire block the first address, it is usually it is not assigned to any of the device. This address, it will be representing that for the entire organization to the rest of the world. So when we want to identify this particular organization, we will be identifying with this, the first address only. So we will not allocate this address to any of the device inside your organization. Likewise over here you have many other devices. So for here only one device is shown with this IP address. So the entire organization is representing with an IP address 180.70.65.128/this-mask-25 over here. And the third organization is having 201.4.22.3/24 is the device IP address. And for the entire organization, it is having the first IP address of this particular block. It is 201.4.22.0/24. And this similarly for this organization also, this is represented with the block 180.70.65.192/26. So the router will fills the forwarding table. So it will fills only the first address of the organization. So here it is 180.70.65.192/26. It is identified with the interface called M2. Okay. And this one 180.70.65.128/25 is identified with the interface called M0. So if you want to forward any packets to this organization, you have to send only through the interface called M0. Coming to 201.4.22.0/24, it is identified with an interface called M3. Okay, and the last one 201.4.16.0/22 is identified with an interface called M1. Okay, this is how this forwarding table is built. Okay, whenever any pack, whenever any devices is being connected to this router, the router will fill this forwarding table. Based on this, the packets will be forwarded. Okay. So the forwarding table for the router R1 I have represented with the help of IP address and the mask. Okay, the similar way what we'll do is we'll represent this IP address in binary format also. So how an IP address can be forwarded, it is based on destination address. For example, so if you take this IP address, it is mentioned here 180.70.65.192/26. so when it is represented in binary form, the leftmost prefix will be taken, it will be stored. So here the prefix value is 26, so we will write only the first leftmost 26 bits which will be taken from this particular IP address. So 180 is represented by this, and 70 is this one. This is 180, and this 70 is represented in binary form like this, and 65 it is represented here. The next totally here it is 8 bits, here it is 8, and here it is 8, 24. The next 2 bits is taken from this 192, the first 2 leftmost bits, and this alone leftmost 26 bits is considered for identifying the destination address. Okay, so I'll tell you how it is identified. First, we will represent this in the forwarding table like this. So now coming to the second IP address, since it is mentioned 25, so we will extract only the first 25 bits. First leftmost 25 bits from the IP address. So over here, the next address is 201.4.22.0/24. So here it is 201 is represented here like this. 4 it is represented here and 22, and here we are going to take first 24 bits. So this 888, so only 24 bits are considered. The next coming to here, it is 201, this is 4, and this is here we are taking only 22 bits. So 88, and again remaining bits we are taking from the next octet. Okay, so we are considering only the prefix value, prefix first leftmost bits from the IP address. So what happens is that whenever, I'll tell you how it is identified, whenever a packet with a destination address 180.70.65.140 arrives to the router R1, it will go and check in the forwarding table. So either we can represent in this IP address format, or otherwise we can represent in the binary format also. So what happens is that the router R1, the first it will check with the first IP address, the destination address matches with the first leftmost prefix value of the first address. If it matches, then the packet will forward the packet to the, through the interface called M2. Or otherwise, if it does not match, it will go and match with the second IP address which is mentioned in the forwarding table. So that destination address, if it matches with this particular address, it will forward the packet through M0, or otherwise it will go to the next IP address and so on. So we will see how it is done. So 180.70.65.140 we can represent like this. So this is 180 and this is 70 and this is 65 and 140 is like this. Okay, so the first what happens is that the router R1, it will go and check the first first address in your forwarding table. So what happens is, so this 180, it will go and check whether this 26, the leftmost 26 bits are equal in your destination address. If you check here, this is what we have got, right, 11 up to this 11. So here this, if it matches with this particular destination address, no, here you have 11, here you have 10 over here, so it does not match. So now it will go and check for the second IP address. Second IP address, if you see, it will check the first 25 bits. So the prefix value over here is 25, so we are not worrying about the next remaining bits of this suffix value. We are considering only the network address. So here 25, it will be checked, the first 25 bits are taken from this IP address. The same thing we are going to match it with the IP address. So here if you consider, so here you have 1 and this also 1, it matches. So it exactly matches with your IP address. So it, what it does is, this exactly matches with the second address in your forwarding table. So the packet, the router R1 forwards a packet through the interface called M0. So when how this forwarding is done is that, forwarding is done based on when a packet arrives to the router, it will go and check the first the addresses in your IP table, that is forwarding table. This forwarding table can also be represented in this IP in binary form also. When it is represented in binary form, instead of writing all your IP address, we are considering only the network address. So how will you find the IP network address? By extracting only the prefix value. So here /26 is the 26 bits are taken from this, and it will be matched with your destination address. So if the destination address matches with the first 26 bits, the packet will be forwarded through the interface M0, or otherwise it will go and check for the second address in your forwarding table. That is, if it matches with, here the interface is 25, so it matches with the first 25 bits of your IP address, then it will forward the packet through M0. So we are taking an example where you have to find out the forwarding process for this particular destination address 180.70.65.140. You need to find out through which interface you are going to forward the packet. So the first what happens is, you are representing this in binary form. So it is represented like this. First, the router R1, it will go and check whether this IP address matches with your the first address. So if it matches, it will forward the packet through M0 M2. If you see here, it is 11 in the last, here we are having 10, so it does not match. It will go to the second IP address. The second IP address, it exactly matches with this over here. So what happens is that it will forward the packets through M0. Okay, this is how the forwarding is done in classless addressing, where you are going to use mask and also the network address to find out your destination interface number. Okay, coming to this classless addressing, that is what we have seen in classless addressing. It is amount of time required to search in the table is more. Okay, amount of time required to search in the table is more. Search in the table is more. Okay, that is what the disadvantage in case of classless addressing. So coming to classful addressing, it is very simple, where we are having only one entry in the forwarding table. Just it will, whenever a packet arrives, it will go and check in the forwarding table whether it matches, then it will forward the packets through that particular interface. But in classless addressing only, we are matching with the help of a subnet mask. Based on the subnet mask and the destination address, if it matches, then we will forward the packets through the interface. So amount of time required in classless addressing is more when we compare to the time required for forwarding in classful addressing is very less. Okay, when compared to this classless addressing. Okay, this is all about your forwarding of IP packets through destination, based on destination address. Next we will see forwarding based on labels. So now we will see the forwarding based on label. Okay, so we know that there are two types of connection. One is connectionless network, other one is connection oriented network. In connectionless network, it is nothing but it is a datagram approach. That is what we have seen in the last topic, that is datagram approach. It is a connectionless network oriented network, where it is where the forwarding router forwards a packet based on the destination address, right? Based on the destination address, it will go and check in the header of the packet. So based on the head destination address, the packets will be forwarded. Next, coming to connection oriented approach, it is nothing but it's a virtual circuit approach. Virtual circuit approach. So in this, the packet will be forwarded based on the label attached to the packet. That is the second topic, attached to your packet. Okay, routing is based on the contents of the table. That is, it is based on the index or the label which is attached to the table. So based on this, we will be forwarding the packets. So we will see it now. To forwarding based on label, so you can see in this diagram. So whenever a packet arrives with this particular label, it will go and check in the switching table. This is called a switching table. So in the switching table, all your labels are given. It just been indexed over here. So it will go and check for this interface is 2, it has to be connected, and the next label to be sent is 0012. So what happens is a switch will forward this particular packet, switch this particular packet to the interface through 2, and it will be connecting to the next router or otherwise next device. This is how this forwarding is done. So when any packet comes with this label, it will go and check in this switching table immediately. We can get the result and it will switch it very fast. So the time required for forwarding is very less compared with forwarding based on label. So actually in 1980s, several vendors have implemented this type of technology. That is, vendors have implemented this switching technology. So it is called as multi-protocol label switching technology. So what do you mean by multi-protocol, or it is MPLS, multi-protocol label switching is. So this router, so they have replaced the routers. The routers can also act as switches also. So the routers can also behave like a router, and also it can behave as a switches. When behaving like a router, this MPLS, this protocol, this is a protocol, MPLS protocol, will forward the packets based on destination address. Okay, when a device is behaving as a router, this MPLS protocol, multi-protocol label switching protocol, will forward the packets based on destination address. When it is behaving as a switcher, it will forward the packets based on label. Forward the packet based on label. Okay. So this multi-protocol label switching protocol has been, this technology has been approved by IETF. So this IETF approach, they have approved this multi-protocol label switching, where a device can act both as a router and also a switcher. When it is behaving as a router, this MPLS helps to forward the packets based on destination address. When it is acting as a switch, it will forward the packets based on label. So whenever a packet comes to the forwarding to the router or a device like which acts as a switch, it will go and check. If it is acting as a router, means it will extract the first leftmost bits of the mask. It will go and compare with this particular IP address in your destination, this forwarding table, it will forward the packets, or otherwise it will go and check the label, and based on the label it will take the next label and as well as next interface through which the packet can be forwarded. So that's all in your forwarding of IP packets. In forwarding of IP packets, we have seen it can be done on destination address, or it is based on labels. Based on destination address, how routing is, how forwarding is done is, so first it will go and check in the table. So first the forwarding table has to be built. So it will be built like this. So whenever all the device has been connected with router, it will build its forwarding table like this. So after building it, so what happens is, so whenever any IP address comes, it will go and check with your destination address. So destination, the first leftmost bits of the mask is extracted, and it will go and check whether it matches. It will send the particular packet through M2, or otherwise it will go and check with all the IP address like this. Okay, this is how this forwarding is done in case of your in your destination address. In case of label, it is very simple. So it is immediate. Also, we can since it is indexed, all your switching table is indexed with this particular label, we can easily extract the information. So here the interface and the next label will be extracted, through which the packets can be forwarded. Okay, there is one technology which has been introduced in the year 1980, that is called MPLS, multi-protocol label switching, where the device can act as both routers and switches. When it is acting as router, it will forward the packets based on destination address, or when it is acting as a switches, it is based on label, it will forward the packets. Okay, this is all about forwarding of IP packets.